Sarah.
Okay, hello.
Hi, Mr. Richard Liu.
Yes.
Okay, các bạn ơi, thầy đã xuất hiện rồi.
Okay, good. Can you
Okay, can you hear me well?
Yes, okay. Yes.
Right. Wow. So happy to have you here.
Nam Hoa. Okay.
Right.
Right.
So, let me introduce a little bit about myself.
Uh-huh.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, so right. My name is Ngân. And okay. that's a Vietnamese name. Just call me Nana because Ngân Khai is difficult for you to say.
I like Nana.
All right, I like it too. So I am working in Seoul as a piano teacher.
Yes.
Yes, and this project, Teach for Draw, is a project that I organize for, it's a non-profit project that I'm organized for Vietnamese piano teacher to develop their career, you know, like in deep learning in some teaching topic. And I know that you are expert in ABRSM. And so I would like to invite you for this live stream interview, and we will have some question discussed about this topic.
Can I put it this way? Is this okay? I should put it this way.
Yes, because I cannot rotate. Okay. So can you introduce a little bit about your music background?
Okay,
we're good now. Can you please tell me again about your music, like music background? I didn't hear.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. As you know, I'm from Malaysia. Okay?
Yes.
And I am. We started learning from very young, and we have been playing using ABRSM music for all our life from the young. Okay.
Oh,
so in Malaysia, it's been since 1970 something. Okay. But I understand in Vietnam, it's only about 10 years since 2008. Okay.
Yes.
So in Malaysia, you know, when you learn piano, you learn music, people will ask you the first question, which grade are you in? You see?
Okay.
They will not ask you how long have you learned. Okay. So everybody is being graded where you are. All right. So this has been going on for Malaysia for a long, long time. So the three countries that is a very high standard and has the most candidates is actually Malaysia, Singapore, and Hong Kong. Okay. So and ABRSM is a very well known. It's over 100 years, and it's one of the most more established exam board, right, comparing to others. You see, so this is most famous actually. And it's still very famous in Malaysia, you know, and many countries. All right. So I've been teaching since a long time ago. I think if you add up together, if Vietnam is more than 35 years, I look young, but I'm very old. Okay. So I've been teaching all my life, and I find that there are a big difference between the Vietnam and what we have been happening in many other countries.
Okay.
So I'm also teaching over here. Okay. So what do you want to know? You know, there's so many things to tell you. I can ask.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
So I just pause for a while and I will translate Vietnamese for audience.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Thì thầy nói rằng là thầy là người Malaysia và thầy dạy piano từ rất là lâu rồi, từ lúc thầy còn rất là trẻ và ABRSM á, thì nó có ở Malaysia năm 1970 mấy á, nhưng mà nó ở Việt Nam thì khoảng chừng 10 năm trở lại đây thôi. Và khi mà những cái bạn học sinh mà học piano tại Malaysia thì luôn được hỏi một câu hỏi đầu tiên là con giỏi về cái gì, chứ không phải là con đã học bao lâu. Và nói chung rằng là ý thầy rằng là ABRSM nó là một cái gì đó, một cái chứng chỉ đó rất là nổi tiếng ở ba nước, theo như mình nghe được đó là ba nước là Malaysia, Singapore và Hồng Kông. Ok. Rồi thì bây giờ thì tụi mình sẽ nghe tiếp ha. Okay, Richard, Mr. Richard.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes, yes, you can keep going
yeah.
now.
Okay. So I find that a lot of teachers who wanted to know ABRSM or any other international certification, but their lack of confidence and they have not much knowledge because I find the main problem is the language thing.
Okay.
Because
okay.
everything is in English.
All
you
right.
Thì you want to translate that?
Ý của thầy nói rằng là cái vấn đề mà nhiều bạn giáo viên gặp phải khi mà dạy giảng dạy IBRSM đó là về tiếng Anh, bởi vì chứng chỉ này nó sẽ tập trung, không phải tập trung nữa, nhưng mà nó là ở bằng tiếng Anh. Ok, yes.
Yeah. So but I feel that if they would learn, okay, to understand, it shouldn't be a problem. I mean, they were able to learn it eventually. Okay. So that's why I decided to do some training, and I decided to help the teachers and to give out so my experience. Okay, 30 over years of experience
nice.
Is a lot of experience. Okay, and I find that because I love teaching, and I would love to train the teachers here. And we can share. You know, I do not claim to be the best teacher. You know, but I would like to share, and we can share together and learn from each other with other teachers. You know. You know, so to make teaching better, okay, all right.
Yes, thì ý của thầy nói rằng là bởi vì cái lý do đó nên là thầy đến Việt Nam thì thầy rất là mong muốn được chia sẻ những cái gì mà mình đã biết trong khoảng thời gian từng đó thầy đã làm việc, thầy đã dạy ABRSM. Và bởi vì thầy rất là thích dạy, thầy không nói rằng là thầy là giáo viên giỏi nhất. You are not the best teacher. But nhưng mà thầy không nói như vậy, nhưng mà thầy nói là thầy muốn chia sẻ những cái gì mà thầy đã dạy, thầy đã sử dụng và thầy thấy hiệu quả trong khoảng thời gian vừa qua. Yes, that's great. Okay.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Richard, I have a question here.
Okay.
You know, like recently there are a lot of international music certificates
yeah.
in Vietnam, such as yeah. Trinity, LCM, Rock School, AMED, ABRSM. Even
yeah.
though it's a good opportunity for Vietnamese teacher and student to join the international music education program, but it makes people confused because they have no idea which one is better. So do you have any advice?
Well, I have been teaching and I've been using and was learning ABRSM since I was young, okay? And I find that I would prefer ABRSM in the sense that it is more widely known and more over the 93 countries. And in many countries, it's more popular.
Okay.
Though every other exam board, every board has its good and bad. You know, there's no such thing as a not a good board, you know. But I have, since Malaysia has been using this ABRSM all this time, you know. So I prefer to use ABRSM, you know. There are some people who claim that the other exam board is a little bit easier, you know, and things like that. So I would say the teachers should take a look at the syllabus of each board, okay, before she decided or he decided to go into the exam, you know. And but I think the ABRSM is a good choice. Truly. Okay.
Thì, yeah, okay. Let I, yes. So, thầy nói rằng là bởi vì chứng chỉ ABRSM nó rất là phổ biến và nó có mặt ở trên 93 quốc gia. Và ở Malaysia thì mọi người sử dụng chứng chỉ ABRSM trong cả việc học và trong cả việc dạy luôn, là nó rất là phổ biến. Và một số những cái quan điểm khác cho rằng thì một số những cái chứng chỉ khác thì có thể là dễ dàng hơn, nhưng mà thầy nói rằng là có thể là trước khi mà các giáo viên huấn luyện thi cho học sinh á thì nên xem những cái chương trình thi để mà chúng ta có thể lựa chọn ra những cái mục tiêu phù hợp cho học sinh. Okay, so you think that before teacher they you know they train their students for any international certificate, they should look at a syllabus, right?
Yeah.
So they can have
yes.
the
they which know. Syllabus that they like, you know.
Yes.
But I think more or less every syllabus is about the same. But we just, because the ABISM is more established and it's the, one of the biggest, you know. Mm. So I don't see, you know,
How do you how do you think about Rock School? Do you ever hear about Rock School?
Yes, okay. There are some teachers who teach that in Malaysia. And I do not really understand the syllabus, okay? And I guess maybe some young people will be interested in more of the rock rather than classical. So it actually depends on how about the students and the teachers, you know, how they want it. That's why I would encourage the teachers to look at the syllabus and see if they have any support in the place that they are staying, you know, or else they cannot take the exam, you know, there's no point, you know. So take a look at the syllabus first, okay?
Okay. Right. Thì thời khuyên của thầy rằng là mọi người nên xem, mọi người nên cân nhắc cái chương trình học để mà nó phù hợp với lại cái mục tiêu của học sinh, để mà chúng ta có thể có những cái lộ trình phù hợp cho học sinh. You know, like some piano student, they you know, they like the classical music.
Mm.
But some they just like modern music. And
yeah,
that's how we just consider the...
You see, let me tell you how I teach. I don't just teach classical, you see.
Okay.
If you're taking the ABISM exam has also jazz inside. Okay? There's jazz pieces in ABISM exam, you see. So you don't just play classical. You do play other contemporary type of pieces. Okay?
Ah.
Now, it all depends on how you teach. You see, I do teach contemporary, I teach jazz, I teach class, even pop songs. You know, the chords, I teach a lot of things to my students.
Wow.
Okay? The most important is to make music interesting. And the ABLSM or the Trinity or the MF, it's all just a part of exam. Where the exam is good, where you have a goal, you know, and you can move up and see the goal and you improve yourself.
Yes.
But for me, it's what you learn, you know, to upgrade yourself. That is important. Okay. Mm. So can I add in some things? When I wanted to teach, decided to teach back in Vietnam, okay, when a lot of people ask me to teach Vietnam, I find that there is not many books around in Vietnam to teach students. So that's why I bring in books and things like that. And I have a variety of different books to teach each grade of students, you know. And they have different types of books. Maybe later I will show you just some pictures of... I have all the books displayed here. You know, let you have a look at what are the books I'm giving my students. I give my students a lot of books, you know.
Okay.
Not just exam piece, okay?
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Where are you now? I don't know.
I am in Vietnam now, okay?
I mean,
the school.
Where are your book display? I mean,
it's beside me, in front of me now, everything, okay?
Okay.
So we can show you afterward, you know. Because I would recommend the teachers not just to give classical, okay? But to have a more variety of pieces and to make music more interesting, okay? Music is supposed to be more fun, okay? It's not just exam, all right? So that's why, but exam is just a goal setting, so they know where they are, how they improve, build their self-esteem, the confidence. But the most important is to make music as interesting as possible, okay? And
yes,
to encourage your students go further.
Okay.
Translate that.
Yes. Yeah, thì thầy nói rằng là khi mà thầy đến Việt Nam á, thì không có nhiều cái tài liệu, không có nhiều cái tư liệu để mà cho giáo viên dạy nhạc hoặc là giáo viên dạy piano tại Việt Nam sử dụng những cái sách vở này kia. Thì thầy đã mang rất là nhiều sách đến Việt Nam. Và thầy nói rằng bởi vì thầy muốn học sinh thầy có thể gọi là có những cái cơ hội để mà nhìn thấy học được âm nhạc như là một cái bộ môn gì đó thú vị, một cái lĩnh vực thú vị, chứ nó không chỉ là gì đó về classical hoặc không phải là về cổ điển hoặc là về contemporary, có nghĩa là âm nhạc hiện đại. Thì thầy muốn rằng là âm nhạc, bộ môn âm nhạc, khi mà thầy dạy âm nhạc hoặc dạy piano thì nó phải là một cái gì đó hứng thú, vui vẻ cho học sinh học thì nó tốt hơn là mình chỉ tập trung vào cái kỳ thi IBRSM hay là những kỳ thi khác, thì nó cũng chỉ là một cái gọi là một cái mục tiêu, một cái goal để mà giáo viên chúng ta có thể set up được những cái mục tiêu đề ra cho học sinh để mà học sinh có thể gọi là đi có một cái mục tiêu rõ ràng, nhưng mà nó không nên là một cái gì đó quá tập trung. Okay, that's okay. Good. Yes, that's the point, right?
Yes.
So the second question is, is RBZSM accepted at any music school in Western, like Western school?
ABRSM?
Yes.
Of course. It's more than, it's about 93 countries.
92 okay. countries.
Yeah, there's a lot of countries. Okay. All right. So it's really widely accepted in many countries. All right.
So okay. like, for example, if a student, they want to learn higher, like learn deeper in music, but in yes. another country. So can they apply their ABRSM certificate?
Yeah, of course. I have students who, most of my students are actually foreigners here, okay? And they travel from one country to country. So after they go through with me, they have a few grades with me, and then when they go to another country, they will continue with that in another country. Yeah. Mm. Okay. And actually, the certificate from the ABRSM for the higher grades, you can actually use it for get credit merit points to enter university in the future. You know, you can use it as a credit point. So you have, So there's something good about it, you know, like, you know, like something like an extra curriculum thing, credit
yes.
points.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Thì thầy nói rằng là, cái chứng chỉ ABRSM nó được gọi là được chấp nhận trên 93 quốc gia và một số những cái trường nhạc, không phải là một số nữa, nhưng mà những quốc gia này, những cái trường nhạc thì họ chấp nhận cái chứng chỉ này để mà các bạn học sinh có thể học lên được những cái gọi là học cao hơn về âm nhạc. Và khi mà các bạn ấy vào đại học á, thì những cái chứng chỉ này nó cũng có thể là tạo ra những cái số điểm cho các bạn ấy để mà giống như là cái entrance, giống như là cái đầu vào của các bạn ấy có thể là có nhiều cái điểm hơn, theo mình nghe là như vậy. Okay, so
okay.
You know, like there are not many piano books for technique exercise in ABRSM course. In your opinion, to gain proper skill for repertoires in the practical exam, should teachers teach students with the extra technique book? Or shouldn't they? If yes, can you please give some book title that could be used? So can you please some good like technical books that teacher can use to teach student for the ABRSM repertoire?
I understand. Okay. Now, techniques is one of the books that I will give every grade. You know, so they have to progress from one book. Okay. Some of the easiest one I give to my students. Okay,
a dozen a day.
This is good enough for a very beginner. Okay, even my students who just started for a few months, they will start with this. A very young, 6 years old, we can do that. You know,
how old is he?
Let's say the student just started, maybe 6 years old, 5 years old. We can do this. It's no problem. Okay, it's all the books depends on the student. You know whether how good they are. Then progress to the progress to the blue color, and then the progress to the green ones.
Okay.
You know, okay. So these are for the beginners, all right. And there are actually many technical books, and I will give to all my students. And the other one that I will give to my students is this one is called for grade one, Tuneful Grade Studies. I like this. Okay.
Is what it is?
This is about techniques. Okay, so these books are I have with me for past 20-30 years. So I collected all the good books and I find these books are very good, and I have proven this, and I really give to all my students every time. And after that, they go to higher grades. They will go to let me get the other books. They will go to Shani.
Jack Ni.
The 599. This is for about grade 3 onwards, okay? So just now was the beginner, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, and then they go higher, some more, they go to 299.
Okay.
These are the technical books I must give. All my students must play the technical book, okay? Of course, students do not like the technical book. They say, oh, it's boring, you know, you don't have music, nice music, all right? But I always explain to the students, you know, why is it necessary? If your technique is good, then you can perform better, you know? So these are the technical books I'm giving my students now.
Yes, okay, which I like. You, the first one is a dozen a day, but the second one, can you spell its name? I couldn't see it.
Is this. Teamwork Great Studies. Okay.
Okay, that's so interesting. Can you just tie you just tie the title on the comment? A comment?
Type. Okay. How to type?
Thank you so much.
I think you can search it online to get a picture of it, you know.
Okay,
Teamful,
I will try.
It's Teamful. Teamful Graded Studies.
Okay? Teamful Graded Studies.
Okay.
So so in Vietnam, you know, like we don't have many books. So but you got it from Malaysia, right?
I got a lot of books here. I bring a lot of books. I have one big cupboard of a lot of books.
All right.
Many books.
So you know where we can buy them in Vietnam. You know where we can get it in Vietnam.
No, they are not available in Vietnam. Okay. This is why I go back to Malaysia, I bring in the books. I try to provide the books from some teachers here, and hopefully it will give them more repertoire to play. Other than that, there are a lot of different type of books. I mean, if you want talking about jazz or contemporary, very beautiful books. All the students like it. All the students like jazz, you know. And I tell you, if I recommend to you, there's a lot of books, okay? So I don't know how to tell you, there's too many books here. Actually, I display some books here.
To me, I'm interested in a technical book.
Yeah.
So I would like to, you know, buy some books.
You should think of the other than technical books, which is also very interesting. Guaranteed to make the students very happy.
Which one?
Like we have give me jazz. Jazz books.
Jazz Lu.
Jazz, okay.
Jazz Lu.
Jazz duet. Okay.
Is that
jazz,
technical?
Jazz duet. Okay. Contemporary we have lyric moments, okay, romantics, reflections, a lot. They're all very, very beautiful books. Music for students, maybe from grade 2, grade 3, grade 4, you know. They are not classical, okay.
And
so
where
I give
we
my
can,
students this one.
Where we can buy it in Vietnam?
I know you're going to ask me this question. Well, can't find it right now, okay, not at all, okay. And I'm providing it to the teachers I'm training, giving training. So I tell them what books to give, how to give, and things like that, you know. It's all from my collection, okay, from many years of collection. So when I find a book, oh, this is very good, you know, and the students like it, so I would keep all these books and compile it, you know, and I share it with my friends and teachers here. So maybe one day if anybody can contact us and and we can share with you.
okay.
So there's too many books actually. There's too many books.
All right. So I hope one day that when I come back to Vietnam, we can meet each other and then maybe I can.
Yeah. Where are you now?
I'm in Seoul, South Korea.
Really? Okay. I thought you're Hanoi. Okay. Okay.
All right. So yeah, that's interesting. I like book too. Okay. Let's translate a little bit. Thì hồi nãy mình có hỏi với thầy về những cái kỹ thuật, những cái cuốn sách mà để dạy kỹ thuật á. Thì các bạn biết rằng ở Việt Nam thì không có nhiều sách dạy kỹ thuật. cái cuốn mà chúng ta học được nhiều, học từ trước đó giờ đó là Method Rose, và sau đó thì có một số cuốn sách như là Little Mozart, rồi một số cuốn như là Poco, Pino Poco. Yeah. Thì mình không thấy nhiều sách dạy kỹ thuật, và mình thì quan tâm đến cái kỹ thuật của học sinh, nên là mình hỏi thầy. Thì thầy có đưa ra một số cái đầu sách như là cuốn A Dozen A Day. A Dozen A Day, cái cuốn này mình cũng biết. Đây là cái cuốn mà có những cái bài luyện ngón rất là ngắn và rất là đơn giản, và nó cũng minh họa rất là dễ thương nữa. Nó dành cho lứa tuổi từ 6 đến 7 tuổi. Thì có gì mình sẽ lát nữa mình sẽ type cái tên của cuốn sách này ở trên cái comment, các bạn có thể nhìn thấy. Cái cuốn thứ hai thì mình không nhìn thấy được nó là cuốn tên gì, nên là mình sẽ hỏi thầy lại. Cuốn thứ ba thầy có đưa ra là cuốn Sagni Open 599, là cái cuốn này mà mình cũng có chúng ta cũng có sử dụng rồi, trong một số trường nhạc chúng ta cũng có được học về Sagni. Ok, thì đây là những cuốn sách mà thầy đưa ra lời khuyên là chúng ta có thể sử dụng để dạy technique cho học sinh. Ok. So now here is our four question. You know, theory, music theory sometimes is a hard part for some children, a difficult part for some children. And you think which age the children can start to do the theory A visual as them grade one, and how to make the theory fun, more fun?
Okay. Usually, if the student is about 6-7 years old, they actually can take a grade one exam. Okay, it depends on the maturity. And of course, we are talking about the language here. If they could not understand English at all, it's a little bit more difficult. Though in the ABSM, when you apply, you can have a translator translating for the exam, the translator or translating theory paper. But I confident that Vietnam parents, okay, and the students would like to learn music in English, because I feel that everybody likes to learn another language. So why not learn it in music too, you see? So the reason I feel that the teachers or the students might feel is difficult about theory is because they did not start from the beginning. When I first teach a student, a very beginner student, they do start a theory book. I teach theory and a practical at the same time. Okay, so they do learn theory, you know, so from very young. So if they learn from very young, they would not have problems. And we have, of course, music books for beginners and every grade. Okay, so if they go through it step by step, they would not have problems. Okay, I think it's because why is it difficult? Because some students never take the foundation. They never learn the basic foundation, and suddenly they say, "Oh, I want to take a grade three," you know, and they will find it a bit difficult. Okay, so we should start as fast as possible the theory classes and to learn more. Okay, then by the time they want to take the exam, they will have no problem. It's everything takes some time, because theory takes some time to understand. Students need to have a certain maturity to take the exam. Like grade one, you should be about 7 to 8 years old, somewhere like that, you know, because you need to count fractions, you know, what's quarter, what is half, what is, you know, you must add all these things. So they need to have certain maturity. If it's too young, there's no points, you know, difficult for them. All right.
Yes, I agree with you that the children need some maturity. But do you think that, I don't know, in my opinion, in my experience, my own experience, that music, like music theory was something boring. I mean, the teacher, they just stand over there and they just talk blah, 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 something. And we, the children, have to remember all of them. Sometimes we understand it, but sometimes we don't get it. So, in your opinion, how to make the music theory more fun?
First, I think the students should learn theory from day one.
From day one.
So they get used to it, you know, they get used to it, okay? they have to understand that whatever learned in theory will apply to the practical. Okay, so the students should understand that what they learn in theory is very important. Okay, I find that if the teacher, okay, or the parents, okay, explain to the student why is it important to learn the theory, all right, they will understand. But I find that there are many teachers in Vietnam who doesn't teach theory. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So when suddenly out of nowhere, then you suddenly put a give a theory, they will not feel happy about it because they're not used to it. That's one thing. Okay. And they do not understand why they need to learn theory. Okay. So you need to, we need to explain. It's the same thing like the technical book. Some students do not like to play the technical book because they say it's boring. Okay. But I always explain to the students why is it important. You know, if a technical book will teach you how to play, the perform better in the future, you know, then you have to explain why the theory is important. You see, so if you are, you know the theory and you know the practical well, then you understand what is all music about. All right. So okay, it's a job of the teacher or parents to explain the importance of the theory first. You know.
Okay. Yeah. So one more question. If the parents, they just look at music, like piano lesson, as a entertainment, you know, like sometimes just for fun, and maybe the children will look to the piano lesson as that way, like, you know, just for fun. So they don't really care. They don't. Okay, if the teacher explains that music is like theory important, but the children, they don't see it. They don't, you know, they don't take it seriously.
Yeah.
So how we can?
So everything have to change from the mindset, from the teacher, from the parents to the students. Okay. That's why I have been encouraging certain schools to teach theory. But when the principal asks the teacher to do it, the teacher doesn't do it. So I think that if we change our mindset, okay, things can happen. All right, okay. Because this is what's happening in many countries. Everybody will know. I give an example to my students. Okay, one day I will teach you how to compose the music, but if you do know how to write it out, it's no point. Okay, all right, because one of the goals of my teaching is to get my student to compose something and to write, able to write it out. All right, so everything applies together. Okay, so that's why I when I teach, you know, we always explain to the students why is it this important, why is that important, and slowly, you know, we will change the mindset. All right, so everything needs to do that. You know, it works okay. Everybody must work together, the parents, the teachers, the students. You know,
Okay, so let's translate a little bit.
Okay.
Thì mình hỏi thầy á rằng là bao nhiêu tuổi thì trẻ mới có thể gọi là bắt đầu học luyện thi chứng chỉ lý thuyết ABRSM music theory, thì thầy nói rằng là ít nhất là 6-7 tuổi, mà nó tùy thuộc vào cái độ gọi là độ chứng chắn, độ trưởng thành của đứa trẻ, vì nó cần những cái kỹ năng như là đếm số hoặc là viết, và đôi khi cái chứng chỉ này nó có thể hơi khó một chút với trẻ em Việt Nam, bởi vì một số trẻ sẽ chưa có hiểu về tiếng Anh một cách đầy đủ. Và nhưng mà rất là thú vị ở Việt Nam, bởi vì ở Việt Nam thì các quý gọi là các bạn phụ huynh thì rất là muốn cho trẻ được học thêm một cái ngôn ngữ nào đó. Vậy thì tại sao không học âm nhạc, không học tiếng Anh thông qua âm nhạc? Và khi mà nói về cái việc rằng là vì sao lý thuyết âm nhạc nó lại khó như vậy, thì thầy nói là có thể rằng là một số giáo viên đã không dạy lý thuyết âm nhạc từ những cái buổi đầu tiên. Và đối với cái việc rằng là khi mà chúng ta không dạy từ buổi đầu tiên và chúng ta bắt đầu không có cái nền tảng, không có cái foundation, thì nó sẽ gây ra cái những cái sự khó khăn cho trẻ. Ok. Và khi mình cũng có hỏi một câu rằng là nếu như mà một số phụ huynh họ chỉ muốn rằng là con học để vui thôi hoặc là để giải trí thôi, và trẻ cũng chỉ học để giải trí, thì làm sao mà chúng ta có thể gọi là giải thích về cái việc, cái tầm quan trọng của gọi là lý thuyết âm nhạc được? Thì thầy mới nói rằng là cái việc này thì nó cần phải thay đổi về cái tư duy, cái mindset của mình. Và thầy cũng đưa ra một cái ví dụ, đó là khi mà thầy dạy composing là sáng tác á, khi thầy dạy sáng tác á, thì lúc này đòi hỏi người học, đòi hỏi trẻ phải có những cái skill, và những cái skill này nó nằm ở trong cái lý thuyết âm nhạc, và có thể là cái điều này nó sẽ thúc đẩy cho đứa trẻ gọi là muốn học lý thuyết âm nhạc nhiều hơn. Okay, so that is long, long, long question.
Okay.
What time is it in Vietnam?
Vietnam, what time is it?
It's 11, right?
It's 11:10, yeah, around there.
Okay. So here's the next question. You still okay?
I'm still okay. Actually, there's a lot of things to tell you. You're never able to finish.
All right. So, like in music theory, adding breath, there are units, the lesson like adding breath, beam note, grouping note is one of the difficult units to teach. And for the early elementary, it's hard to have them understand. Do you have any advice about this?
Great one. Okay.
Yeah, so we're talking about the adding rest, beaming notes, and grouping notes.
Yes. Actually, I am using this book. Okay? There are many books in Malaysia. Okay? There's many, many books in Malaysia. Okay? There's also ABSM books. Okay?
Young musicians.
Okay? Yes. So, this book, actually, I like this book, okay, because it has a very good explanation, okay, and after the explanation, you have exercise to do. This is for grade one, okay, this is for grade one, you see, and at the end of it, you have a revision notes, okay, and the revision note, they have all the notes that you need to know for that grade, okay, so what you're talking about, like, beaming, okay.
Yes, beaming.
Rest. Yeah, beaming and rest. Everything it's step by step. You see or not? It's from the early stage beginner. And they have the beginner's book, and by the time they finish this book, okay, they'll be ready to take exam. Now, this book I usually let my student do within 8 months. Eight months. The reason is BS. Because after they finish this one, they are supposed to do test papers. They're supposed to do test papers. Right? Then after they do test papers for maybe a 1 month or 2 months, they will take the exam. They will have very good result. Okay? Guaranteed. All right. So that's why it's a matter of, it's a step-by-step thing, is it not? So there are many questions. Yes, I understand that the grouping, the rest, everything, you see, like example, this is a grade two. Okay, this is a grade two. Okay, at the end of it, they have a revision notes. They will explain to you how to write the rest, how to write the notes. If the students go through these books, they are also different type of books, but I like these books. They will not have problems. They have step explanation. Explanation, they have exercise for you to do. You see?
Yes.
So, if they do a lot of exercise and then they do test papers for the exam, they don't have any problems. Okay? So, I do encourage the teachers to get the books, the right books, and teaching theory actually is not a difficult thing. My students, even Vietnamese, okay, they are 6, 7 years old. You still can do a grade one exam.
Okay. Thì, yes, that I translate. Thì khi mà mình hỏi là về cái bài học về gọi là trong tiếng trong ABSM nó có một cái bài đó là adding notes, beaming notes, rồi grouping notes, rest đó có nó giống như là gom, nó giống như nó gọi là nối những cái dấu lặng và những cái nốt đúng với cái phách, cái nhịp của cái gọi là cái nhịp của cái câu nhạc đó. Thì mình hỏi rằng là làm sao để mà đây là một cái phần rất là khó để mà chúng ta giải thích cho học sinh. thì khi mình hỏi làm sao để mà có thể giúp học sinh có thể làm bài được và hiểu cái này nhiều hơn, thì thầy có suggest một số những cái tên sách, không phải là một số nhưng mà thầy suggest một cuốn sách về theory, đó là cuốn Music Theory for Young Musicians. Thì thầy nói rằng là có thể bắt đầu cái cuốn này vào khoảng lúc mà 6-7 tuổi, thì học khoảng 8 tháng. Học 8 tháng xong thì làm cái giấy, làm cái đề thi, làm cái đề thi, cái cuốn đề thi của ABGSM á, là trẻ có thể giải quyết được những cái câu hỏi một cách dễ dàng. Alright, so now we will move on to the last question, and we will answer some questions from the audience today. Và các bạn, nếu như mà các bạn có những cái câu hỏi nào đó về ABRSM thì các bạn cũng đặt câu hỏi liền ngay cho thầy để mà chúng ta có thể nhận được câu trả lời trong, để mà nhận được câu trả lời trực tiếp ngày hôm nay nhé. Okay, so let us see. We also have some technical question about teachers as you know, like 6-4 time signature, compound time or simul time. The time signature, yes.
Yes. 6-4 means 6 quarters.
Yes, 6-4 time signatures.
Okay, this is great for all. Okay, so.
That's a compound book, or simul.
Oh, that's why it's compound time. 6-4 means by the grouping, it has to be right. 3 count together and then 3 count together. So 6-4 has only 2 beats. 6-4 has 2 beats. Yes, okay. So it's a compound time. Okay? It's 2 dotted mini beats. All right. You will learn it since grade 4, I think. Yeah.
Okay. So
okay, so
you mean like 6-4 has 2 beats, right?
Yep.
There's a 1 beat is
dotted mini.
Dotted,
three count. So each beat is 3 count.
3 counts.
Dotted minim.
Dotted minim.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Interesting. All right. Yeah.
You have to know the beat is important because it's a way of you playing it. So it will tell you the way to play the music beats. So how many beats is very important. Right? Same thing like 6-8.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Thì, let's I translate. Thì mình có hỏi một cái câu hỏi từ trong từ một bạn thành viên của dự án, đó là nhịp 6-4 là nhịp đơn hay là nhịp kép. Thì thầy nói rằng là nhịp 6-4 gồm có 2 phách mạnh và một phách là một nốt trắng chấm. Vì thế mà nhịp 6-4 là có 2 nốt trắng chấm cộng lại với nhau. Thì đây là một nhịp kép, đây là compound time. Ok. Hy vọng rằng là bạn thành viên này đã nhận được câu trả lời như mình muốn. Okay, so Mr. Richard, do you want to share something else about
music? Yes. Okay.
Yes.
I would advise the teachers to look into any examination board. Okay. If depending what they like. Example like the ABRSM, because I feel that in the future the parents would want the children to take ABRSM exam. You know, this is the future thing that's coming in. You know, the new generation will search about examining board and things like that. So if you are a teacher and you do not know about ABRSM, and then you will be like in a losing side.
Sure.
Okay, you see? So you should know a certain board, not just if it can be any board, if you like Trinity or LCM, you know, or I think that, but you should stick to one, okay? Get familiar yourself with one. And then you should promote this to the parents and to the students. I find that if the students have a goal that they are taking, oh, I'm taking grade 2 next year. You know, they have a goal, oh, I'm taking grade 3 next year. They have a goal, they will know where they are going.
Sure.
And they will continue to learn. If they do not have a goal, they will stop learning because there's no purpose. Okay? All right? So, this examining board is to show the students which standard they are and what they need to improve. All right? So I think to sit for an exam is important. But of course, there are some students who do not want to take exam at all. Okay. But from my experience, the students who sit for exam every year will continue for a long, long time. All right. Now, I understand the teachers here has the problem about the English because ABLSM is in English. Okay. I will advise them to learn the music English and to teach in English. Okay. Because, you know, after some time, you use the same words in English. It's not a difficult thing. You get what I mean? You know? And the parents here will slowly like a teacher who can teach some English words, teach the children English, or maybe talk to the children in English. I think it's a plus thing. Okay? The teachers should upgrade their mindset to improve for the future. Okay? And if you're able to change your mindset, then you can tell the parents about the future of music education, what it's about, you know, things like that. And I think this is a very important thing, all right? I just feel that some teachers in Vietnam do not like to learn something new. They just want to stay there, you know? They just want to stay there and they're so comfortable, you know, things like that. But from what I see in the future, okay, 3 years, 5 years, everybody will talk about examination board, okay? And if you are not into this, okay, you will be like outdated, okay? So we have to do something now.
Yes. Okay, so let's I talk in Vietnamese. Thầy có một cái lời khuyên cho những cái bạn cho những bạn giáo viên dạy piano tại Việt Nam, đó là trong khoảng chừng khoảng thời gian sắp tới 3-5 năm thì cái đây không phải là cái xu hướng nữa, nhưng mà rằng là mọi người nên chuyên tâm trong một cái lĩnh vực, trong một cái gọi là cái lĩnh vực chứng chỉ quốc tế nào đó, không hẳn là ABRSM, các bạn có thể là về LCM, về Trinity, về Rock School, bất cứ cái nào cũng được, nhưng mà đây là một cái để mà cho các bạn luôn luôn giữ cho các bạn kịp thời với lại cái xã hội, với sự phát triển của xã hội, sự phát triển của giáo dục âm nhạc. Bởi vì nếu như mà chúng ta gọi là chúng ta cứ ở trong một cái trạng thái rằng là bình thường á, comfortable, chúng ta ở trong comfort zone á, thì chúng ta sẽ không có học được cái gì mới, và chúng ta cũng cảm giống như là bị outdated, giống như là bị lỗi thời á trong cái việc giảng dạy. Mà thầy cũng nói rằng là khi mà những cái bạn học sinh tham dự những cái kỳ thi quốc tế như là ABRSM hoặc là LCM, Trinity gì đó, thì các bạn ấy sẽ học trong một khoảng thời gian dài và duy trì cái việc học nó dài hơn, nó lâu hơn là những bạn không có tham gia. Mr. Richard? Richard? Ok. Mọi người, nếu như mọi người có những câu hỏi nào đó về ABRSM, bất cứ câu hỏi nào thì mọi người có thể gửi phần comment nhé. Ở đây thì mình thấy rằng là các bạn chưa có câu hỏi nào hết. Ok. Rồi. Đây là phần 3 mọi người ơi. Chúng ta còn khoảng 15 phút, mọi người hãy đặt câu hỏi nhé.
Okay,
you're back. All right. So I think we have like 10 minutes.
Okay.
Yes, 10 minutes more. Okay. So like If somebody like, do you have any advice for the piano teacher who are working on, who are the IBRSM teacher? Mm. Do you have any advice for them? Like me, I am an IBRSM teacher.
Okay. Okay. Well, from what I know about teachers now is that being able to teach is one thing. Being able to play or perform is another thing, all right? So you may be good in performing, but you'll be very difficult for you to teach because you are so good in playing, you know? So you have to be very patient, okay? You have to make, you have to find ways to make students understand. And for me, I like teaching because for me it's a very fun thing, and I have a lot of fun with my students. You know, we joke and we have fun, and I have some funny games. I use many type of things to make lesson more interesting. Like we have flashcards, we have the cup beat, you know, rhythm meeting, and a lot of things. I do a lot of things. Okay, so things will be interesting, and you have to. Have a good communication with the student, all right? To make the student like, oh, they like you. If they like you, they like music, okay?
Yes.
In the past experience, a lot of people stop playing piano is because they don't like the teacher, okay? That is true, okay? I mean, I'm telling you the truth, okay? So, you cannot take teaching too seriously, okay? All right? If you have a right attitude to teach, okay, and then and you make teaching a fun thing for you, then it will be fun for the student. But if you take teaching as something that a big career and you are very too serious and you want all the students to get a very good result, things like that, then the students will feel very stressed. And because students now, they have so many activities in school and they are so busy in school and they have so many games to play in the internet, okay? So they have no time to play the piano, all right? So, yeah. So,
but how about if we, like, if the student don't have good result, result, and how about the parents? Parents, you know, they blame on the teacher and...
Yes, yeah. So that's why there must be a good communication between the parents, the teacher, and the parents, the teacher, and the student. All these things they have to understand each other. I know there will be good students, there will be bad students. There will be good parents, and there will be bad parents. Okay, all right. So it's how we communicate with each other. All right. So I have a good relationship with everybody. Okay. And if I do feel comfortable with somebody, then I say, sorry, then I cannot teach because it will not work, you see. The most important thing is the students enjoy the lesson, the class, and they learn something, and they will go far. If the students do not enjoy the class, it will be a short-term thing. It will not last long. There's no point, you see. So it's when the student is good, how do you inspire, as a teacher, inspire the students to become better? Okay, so but I find that a lot of teachers here, they're just using, hold on, I got this. They're just using the exam piece to teach. This is the exam piece, okay? All right, and they only teach the pieces inside here. We should try to have, like I show you many books. We have many books to make piano playing more fun, not just for exam piece, okay? Exam piece should take about 4 months to teach. That's it. Okay? The rest of the time, you have to upgrade and you have many, many pieces, many, many books to teach, you know, to give the students to play. All right? Do not, because I personally have seen some teachers teach this one for 1 year. Okay? So it's going to be very boring. All right? So it's no fun.
Sure.
All right? Okay? So try to find books. Try to find fun ways to teach. Have good communication and everything, and then teaching will be more fun. This is actually we need to inspire the student, you know, then you will work, you know.
Okay. Yes, so yeah, that's I translate.
Okay.
Thì thầy nói rằng là đối với những giáo viên mà đã đang dạy luyện thi chứng chỉ rồi á, thì thầy khuyên rằng là chúng ta nên có cái sự gọi là cái sự giao tiếp tốt với học sinh. Và khi mà học sinh thích mình á, thì học sinh mới có thể thích học piano được. Đôi khi có những học sinh không có học piano bởi vì đơn giản là không thích giáo viên. Và ngoại trừ cái việc là chúng ta chỉ tập trung dạy vào những cái bài gọi là những cái bài thi á, những cái bài practical hay là những cái chứng chỉ lý thuyết á, thì chúng ta cần phải tìm hiểu những cái hoạt động và những cái sách vở, những cái tài liệu để mà làm cho cái giờ học nó trở nên vui hơn và nó trở nên thú vị và hấp dẫn hơn. Và từ đó chúng ta có thể gọi là inspire, giống như gọi là kích thích cái tình yêu âm nhạc, cái tình yêu môn học piano ở trong học sinh nhiều hơn. Và thầy cũng có mention là cái cuốn sách mà exam piece, có nghĩa là những cái bài thi practical á, bây giờ exam thì nó chỉ trong cần 4 tháng thôi. Và nếu mà chúng ta dạy trong một cái quá trình mà chúng ta chỉ dạy một cái cuốn đó thì nó sẽ rất là nhàm chán. Ok. Và phụ huynh với giáo viên thì cũng cần phải giao tiếp tốt với nhau, có một cái mối quan hệ tốt với nhau để mà có thể hiểu được nhau. Và đôi khi thì có những phụ huynh cũng hay đổ lỗi cho việc là học sinh con của mình không có đạt được kết quả tốt là bởi vì giáo viên không có những cái phương pháp dạy tốt. Thì trong trường hợp đó chúng ta nên có những cái sự giao tiếp tốt, mối quan hệ tốt với phụ huynh để mà phụ huynh có thể hiểu được phương pháp giảng dạy của mình. Ok, so here's a question. Finally we have one. She said that and Kim An, she said that she just heard about like a teacher trained student for the international certificate. And how about a teacher? Should they, you know, should they apply for? Yeah, should they take that too?
Actually, I do encourage the teachers to try and take the exam. Okay. Like you just take the a grade 5 theory, you know, just to get the experience of it, and you know, just take the one or two exams on the practical side to make them more confident, you see, to make them more confident. I think it's a good way to do that. All right. So well, I do encourage. Okay.
Right. Yes. Thì thầy có trả lời đó anh, thầy nói rằng là giáo viên cũng nên thi chứng chỉ ít nhất là grade 5 để mà chúng ta có cái đôi khi là có những cái kiến thức nền cho cái việc giảng dạy và chúng ta cũng có cái sự tự tin nữa. Thì như vậy thì chúng ta sẽ gọi là đi lâu dài hơn. Bởi vì đôi khi có những cái gọi là khái niệm cho âm nhạc nó bằng tiếng Anh thì nếu mà mình tự tìm hiểu thì cũng tốt, nhưng mà Ngân nghĩ là mình cũng nên thi một cái Ray. Ngân nghĩ là Ray 5 là tốt. Okay, Mr. Richard, we are honored to have you here today.
Okay. Do you want to see some of the books and just a
yes,
video
sure,
to shoot
sure,
some of the
yes.
books I put it in? These are the ABLSN books.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, we have Ray 5, 4,
yeah,
5,
everything.
6, 7, 8.
These are the books we give for the beginners. Okay. Lots of books over here. Some also books, ABLSN books. Okay. These are some of my books. I have too many books to bring over. These are some of my books. Okay. And then we have also different kind of books for young children. Yeah.
Okay.
Too many books around. Okay. I just show you some of the books here. Okay.
Nice.
Some of the jazz books, you know. All right. So I have some contemporary books, you know. There's too many books. Okay. All right. I have, because I have collected for over 30 years, so for me it's my students do not have enough time to play all my books. Sometimes so a student, yeah, sometimes a good student can have can play about 7 books at the same time. I have students who play 7 books okay. at the same time. Yeah, because there's so many books to play and you... they like it. Okay, so and I do not like those taken from the internet because they are not graded. You don't know the standard of each book. So when you have those books, then you have the, you know, the standard of each book, you know how, which books to give to the student, and that will help you and help the student. Okay, so I'm sorry that you cannot find the books in Vietnam, some of the books, and so that's why I'm trying to bring in, I buy these books from Malaysia to bring it over.
Do you sell it? I mean,
yeah, I think we'll try to help. So some of them ordered by some teachers, you know, so we try to bring in as many as we can and help. And some things we cannot buy anymore because they are obsolete. Some books cannot even find in Malaysia anymore, you see, because it's difficult to find. But I have it, you know, so for my collection. So I would, you know, trying to share with some teachers. So this is what I'm trying to do, okay?
You know, like you produce a lot of books for us, and but now we have no idea how to get them. So yeah. You should sell it. You should sell them.
Yeah, we have. We'll try. You know, I try to when I just came back from Malaysia yesterday, and I bring all the books in and whatever I can, you know. And I find that it's very important to have the books. So my students, when they have from the beginning, when they start the lesson, and till the higher grade, they collect many, many, many books. They collect a lot of books, so that they can play for fun and anytime they want. So these are the things that I think when I started to teach over here, the teachers do not know what books to give to the student. That is one main problem, you know. So that's why we're trying to explain to the teachers. I'm trying to do some training and I tell them what I actually do now, okay, to my students, you know, what actually I'm practically doing now. Okay.
Do you have, certainly, do you have any training for now so far?
Yeah. We have an ongoing training over here in Ho Chi Minh, okay. So we have some classes and I train some teachers over here. So they are very happy to see all my books. So that is a good thing I've been trying to do.
So the training is for teacher, right?
Yeah, I love to train. I like to train the teachers, you know.
So do you like if the teacher want to take the course, how do they get it? How do they where to contact it?
We will contact Miss Tan, you know, the one, this person who asked me to come for the interview.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean,
we will ask her to put it on the group or whatever, so that whoever wants and I hope that I have time. Okay. And we can share, and not just I train, but sometimes, you know, we can learn from each other, you know, and we can share whatever we have so that we can improve better as a teacher, you know, to give the best thing for our students. Well, I hope to do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so all right. Thank you so much for today, Mr. Richard.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for having me. All right.
Thanks for sharing a lot of things, a lot of information.
Yeah.
And we wish you all the best wish. Yeah. And we have to see you someday with all of that book. Okay.
All right.
Okay, goodbye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Yes. Have Bye-bye. A good day.
All right. You too. Bye.
Yes. Ok các bạn ơi, vậy là livestream đã kết thúc rồi và hy vọng rằng là livestream lần này các bạn đã có những thông tin khá đầy đủ về AVRSM. Mình nghĩ rằng là một số những cái thông tin như là làm sao để đăng ký kỳ thi này và những cái chi phí cho kỳ thi này các bạn có thể tìm kiếm trên Google. Tuy nhiên những thông tin mà trong livestream ngày hôm nay thì các bạn có thể là chỉ có tại livestream ngày hôm nay. Hy vọng rằng là các bạn thích livestream và các bạn thấy nó hiệu quả. Và livestream này là nằm trong dự án hoạt động của dự án Teach for True, là một dự án phát triển dành cho giáo viên Pinon tại Việt Nam. Rất vui vì các bạn đã theo dõi. Chào tạm biệt và hẹn gặp lại.